Hello friends, in this video we are discussing about the discount rate payback period. What is discount rate payback period? Traditionally, as we see, the payback period does not consider the time value of money. That was the major drawback for it. Now, to avoid this drawback, discounted payback period is calculated. In this method, for calculating the payback period, cash flows are discounted at the desired or required rate of return or the cost of capital. Then the payback period is calculated. The method uses terminal value method. Under this method, it is assumed that each cash inflow is reinvested in another assets at a certain rate of return from the moment it is received until the termination of the project, so that the cash flow is maintained in the project. This method is based on the rationale that a firm reinvests its earnings in the business itself, as I have told you, for the continuation cash flow, so that we are getting the earnings from the value which we have profited in the past. In this method, the net cash flows and outflows are compound forward rather than discounting them backward as NVP method. Project will be accepted if the present value of the total of the compound reinvested cash flows is greater than the present value of the outlays. So mutual exclusive project with the higher present value of the total of the compounded cash flow is accepted. So in this method, firstly, cash flows are multiplied by the compounding factors. Assuming that the amount of cash flow is reinvested, and it will earn compound interest till the terminal year. So the main assumption is what? That we are reinvesting the capital we have gained, and we will earn the compound interest till the terminal year. At the end of the terminal year, there will be no reinvestment, and thus compound factor is taken as 1 there. And the second step, some of these compound values are calculated, and then in next step, the sum of so obtained is further discounted at the cost of capital for the year of lifetime to find the present value. And the last step is the amount so obtained in the third step, present value of your compound reinvested cash flows is compared with the present value outflows of cash, and we decide whether to accept or reject the project on the criteria, that is your present value of the compounded reinvestment cash flows should be greater than the present value of outflow. So you can simply say present value of cash flows inflows, it should be greater than present value of outflows. Then accept the project. If it is less, reject the project. If it is equal to 0, then it depends whether to accept or reject the project. For ranking different mutually exclusive projects, calculate the net terminal values. And net terminal values can be found out by using the simple formula. Then rank the projects according to the net terminal values. If we have n number of projects, depend upon that, we can find out which project is more profitable. Then what are the merits? Assuming that the net cash inflow is reinvested once they are received, and avoid any influence of cost of capital on cash flow streams. Then this method of evaluation is very easy, especially mutually exclusive projects, and easy to understand, especially to those businessmen and executives who are no adequate knowledge in accounting and economics. So it is very easy to understand by anyone. And demerit is, the major demerit is that the calculation for the rate of interest need be forecasted or estimated, which is difficult. In this video, we have discussed about the discounting payback period. Thank you.